Morning students, let's see the continuity of 13th group elements. Aluminium and its compounds. Today we are going to discuss about, yesterday we discussed about Al2O3, that is one important compound, and the second compound is aluminium chloride, AlCl3. This is another compound of aluminium. Aluminium is there or not? Yes. It is one of the important compound of aluminium. Al2O3 is one compound, okay? Now, AlCl3, there is two types. One is anhydrous AlCl3, okay? And hydrated AlCl3. Anhydrous means without water. Hydrated means with water. Okay, generally AlCl3.6H2O. In hydrated aluminium trichloride there is 6 water molecules are there, keep it in our mind. So there is no water molecule here. Okay, so these two are very important compounds of aluminium. Okay, now preparation of anhydrous AlCl3 prepared when dry HCl or HCl means hydrochloric acid, you know very well, or chlorine gas Cl2 glass, okay, passed through aluminium turnings means like small pieces. Turnings means here aluminium pieces, small pieces. Okay, aluminium turnings produced AlCl3 vapors and AlCl3 vapors undergoes condensation means here cooling. What is meant by condensation? Cooling here. So when temperature is decreases, what happens suddenly? Vapor converted to liquid. So that means vapor converted to liquid. Okay, that phenomena is called as converted condensation here, cooling, and obtained crystalline solid AlCl3. That is the process. Let's see with the diagram. So what is the diagram here? Now here we have a small tube like arrangement. okay? This is soda lime, that is NaOH plus calcium hydroxide, okay? This is AlCl3 and this is anhydride calcium chloride, okay, with glass wool plug, okay. That means here we keep anhydrous calcium chloride, so a small cotton is arranged here, so anhydrous calcium chloride in cotton and keep at this place. So now what is the advantage of this anhydrous calcium chloride here? If is there any moisture or water vapor enter into this tube, that vapor is attracted by this cotton wool and calcium chloride, okay? So to catch the water moisture, we use here calcium chloride or cotton wool. That means calcium chloride with cotton wool, okay? Keep that place, okay? Now here, this is aluminium foil or aluminium turnings. Turnings means like this small pieces of aluminium turnings, okay? So now we pass the Cl2 gas when passed through this aluminium. This is aluminium, you know, this aluminium interact with this chlorine, this dry chlorine or dry HCl, sulfuric acid, hydrochloric acid, okay? So this one or this one, anyone, when pass into this tube, okay, this chlorine or HCl interact with aluminium and produce AlCl3 vapors, and later it is cooling, it produce AlCl3 solid, which is anhydrous without water, okay? Without water. So simply this aluminium interact with chlorine, interact with this aluminium, simple. Let's see the following equations here regarding that. This is bottle like arrangement, this is bottle.
Treated with
AlCl3. Let's see the corresponding equation. This is aluminium and this is chlorine gas. So what it gives here? AlCl3. Let's see the balance equation. 3 chlorines here, 2 here, 2, 3 is 6 chlorine, keep 3 here, 3, 2 is 6 chlorine, 2 aluminiums, okay, aluminium trichloride is produced here, okay, and next one, next method, Al2O3, write the statement here. When alumina, what is alumina? Al2O3 treated with coke, that is carbon, coke means carbon, and chlorine gas produced AlCl3 and carbon monoxide. Let's see the corresponding equation. Al2O3 when treated with carbon and chlorine gas, okay, so it produces AlCl3 and carbon monoxide. Here it is 3 moles, here it is 3 moles, okay, and here three chlorines here, and here we have 3 6 chlorines, two aluminiums. Balance, okay. This is anhydrous AlCl3. Okay, and now next one, preparation of hydrated AlCl3. So here, when aluminium treated with dilute, where in the above case it is dry, here it is diluted, means some water is there, dilute HCl produce AlCl3 and hydrogen gas. Let's see the equation. So dilute HCl when treated with aluminium, so what it gives? AlCl3 plus 3H2. It consists some water content, okay, keep it in our mind. Now balance this equation here 2, 3 is 6 chlorines, here 6 chlorines, 6 hydrogen, 6 chlorines, and how many aluminiums? 2 aluminiums here. This is main, this consists of quantity of water, so hydrated. Why? Because it is diluted, you know, diluted. And next method in this, when aluminium hydroxide treated with chlorine dilute HCl produced AlCl3 and water. Okay, let's see the equation. AlOH taken thrice plus dilute HCl, it produces. Okay students, are you following or not? What it gives, what is the main product here? AlCl3 and some quantity of water, here it is 3 moles, okay, here 6 hydrogens, here 3 chlorines, keep 3 here, 3 chlorines balance, 3 hydrogens here, and here 3 hydrogens, 6 hydrogen balance, 1 aluminium and 1 aluminium balance, okay, all are balanced, okay. So this is hydrated here, why? Because atmosphere water is there. Some water content is here. So aluminium with water is hydrated. Okay? Hydrated. Okay, clear mark two. So write up to this. Okay. Again, we'll discuss on properties of Al2O3 on tomorrow class. The syllabus what we have in 10th IIT is more than an intermediate. Keep it in your mind. So there is few topics in intermediate, but in your 10th IIT there is much syllabus comparing with intermediate first year and second year also. Okay, keep it in your mind, and there is a lot of information is there. Okay, students, thank you very much.